see you like that.
And then
I'll stay here.
And then you do.
Hand it again to stop.
Thank you.
I take away.
Thank you.
Good afternoon. Miss Hennigan, isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I moved to the ward, 17 in prison. I tried to run away.
Oh, thank you, I'm not!
She was in one of those human fields over to the river with a bunch of bums.
They were bums.
She had a big pumpkin, but he got away.
Oh, poor pumpkin, out for freezing with nothing but this sweat. I hope you didn't catch the flu. Oh, thank you, officer.
I'm glad I did. And you, don't ever let me hear that you ran away again from this sweet, nice lady. Again, good afternoon.
Good afternoon, officer. The next time you walk out that door, it'll be 1953. So, glad to be back.
Yes, Miss Hennigan.
Liar! That's the one thing I say. Not to lie!
Miss Hennigan.
Yes.
I'm Grace Sparrow, private secretary to Oliver Warbuck.
The Oliver!
Don't know you that? Mr. Warbucks has decided to invite an orphan to spend the Christmas holidays with him at his home.
What sort of orphan did he have in mind?
Well, she should be friendly and intelligent.
Mississippi, covered MISSISSIBBI, Mississippi.
And cheerful.
Yeah, shut up. And how?
Oh, age doesn't matter, say 8, or 9, or 10, or 11. Yes, the 11 would be perfect. I know. Mr. Warbucks prefers long, curly-headed children.
11. Long, curly-headed? No, sorry, I'm not looking like that.
What about this child right here?
Annie, no, you don't want that.
Annie, would you like to spend the next 2 weeks at Mr. Warbucks' home?
I would love to.
No, you can have all of them, but not Annie.
Perhaps I call the Board of Orphans and maybe...
Ah!
Do you really live here, or is this a train station?
We really live here.
Bye.
romance and life need not be over.
God, I hope not.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
What's the matter? You about to put out the handy already?
On the contrary. This has to be signed and returned no later than 10 o'clock tomorrow to the Board of Orphans.
What for?
Because Mr. Warwick is so taken with Annie, he wants to adopt her.
Annie? The daughter of a millionaire?
The daughter of a billionaire.
Oh! Would you excuse me for one moment?
Thank you. Alright, we'll talk about it on...
Friday.
Listen, Mr. President, why don't we just bury the hatchet and you and Mrs. Roosevelt come for supper Christmas Eve? You will? Wonderful. Goodbye, Mr. President. Grace, find out what Democrats eat.
Yes, sir.
And the package from Tiffany's?
Arrived this morning.
Fine. I'm going to give it to her and tell her that I went to a doctor.
She's going to be the happiest little girl in the world.
Get her down here.
Yes, sir. Hello.
And we have a man-to-man talk.
Sure. You're sending me back to the orphanage, right?
No, Annie, of course not. Annie, I was born into a very poor family, and both of my parents died before I was 10. It was then that I made a promise to myself that one day I was going to become rich. Very rich.
That was a good idea.
But lately, I've realized something. No matter how much money you've got, if you've got no one to share it with, if you're alone, then you might as well be broke. I was at Tiffany's the other day, and I picked this up for you.
For me? Gee, thanks, Mr. Warbucks. Oh, boy.
It's a silver locket here. I noticed that old broken one you always wore around your neck. And I said to myself, I'm going to get that kid a nice new locket. So, here, we'll just take this old one off and...
No! I don't want a new one.
Andy, what's wrong?
This locket, my mother and father left it for me when they left me at the orphanage. And I know, too. I know I'm real lucky being here with you for Christmas and all. But the one thing in all the world I want is to be like other kids, with folks of my own.
It'll be all right. I'll find them. I'll find your parents.
It's okay, Eve. Mr. Warbucks will find your mother and father. If he has to put everyone in his organization out of job, if he has to pull every political string there is to pull.
Up to and including the White House. Annie, give me your locket.
But Mr. Warbucks.
I understand, but it may be our best clue. The FBI can trace it back when we bought it.
Okay. Maybe you should have my note too.
Amy, you wait. You may be finding out where your parents are within a couple of days.
Really? I might have heard about your kids about this.
Thank you. Dalloway from Weasley. I'm Harry, Harry Potter.
Here's your ticket. Stick to it, Harry. That's very important. Stick to your ticket.
Yeah.
Annie, this isn't just going to be an adoption, it's going to be a celebration. And you could have anyone in the world you'd like to come. So who would you like?
Miss Farrell, and Drake, and Mrs. Q, and, well, everybody here.
Drake.
Yes, sir.
Tell the staff to get all spiffied up. They're going to be the guests at Annie's adoption party.
Oh, and the kids.
Oh, sorry, Annie, but it'll be way past their bedtime. But I'll tell you what, all the kids from the orphanage can come over tomorrow for a big Christmas party.
And Miss Hannigan, too?
Why not? Annie, I'm the luckiest guy in the world.
I'm the luckiest kid.
Together at last, together forever, we're tying a knot that never been severed. I've got the sunshine down.
Thank you.
So that means I am an orphan after all.
Are you all right?
Yes. Because I know that they love me, and they would have come for me if they weren't.
I love you, Candy Bennett.
And I love you too, Mr. Warbucks. Now, who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
Well, the birth certificate could have easily been faked, but no one else knew about the locket except us.
And the FBI, of course.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan.
Yeah!
Which Mike?
Which Mike?
Is it her?
Come on, both of them.
Go ahead, try. Turn the mute off on the bottom.
Okay. All I want to say is we've had a great time with the kids. They put in a lot of hours and a lot of hard work. And I want to thank each one of the parents in the audience for having them here and loving us your kids. So thank you very much.